Now, your book, you mention the word meditation. And I looked it up in the Oxford Dictionary, where it defines it as indulgence in thought. But you don't want us to do this.
One has to go into this, sir. It's really, for me, meditation is one of the most important things. Mm-hmm. And one has to really know what it means.
Can you tell me what it is not? That sometimes
I think that's better. Yeah. I was just going to suggest what it is not. You see, there are various schools of meditation who offer various systems, methods. And they say if you practice these methods, these systems day after day, you will achieve a certain form of enlightenment. experience an extraordinary state. Now, first of all, that is, to me, that's the whole idea of systems method implies mechanical repetition. And that is not meditation. Now, is it possible to not to make the mind dull by repetition, but to be aware of this movement of thought? Yes. Without suppression, without trying to control them, but just to be aware of this whole momentum of thinking, this chattering going on.
But we verbalize our thoughts, don't we, all the time?
That's it. Thought exists only in words or in images.
Mm-hmm. But you see, there's the old punch joke about the old lady asked what she did, and she said, sometimes I sit and thinks, and sometimes I just sit. But what's she doing when she's just sitting? Is she meditating?
No. She's just vague, daydreaming, or lost in some kind of fancy. That's not meditation, good Lord. Meditation means the most extraordinary, demands a great discipline. Not the discipline of suppression or conformity. The discipline that comes when you observe your thinking, when there is an observation of thought, that very observation brings about its own extraordinary subtle discipline. That is absolutely necessary.
Do you set aside time for this?
Sir, you can do it. Any old time. You can do it while you're sitting in a bus. That is, watch, observe, be attentive. What is happening around you, what is happening in yourself, what is aware of this whole movement. You see, and meditation is really a form of emptying the mind of everything known. Otherwise you cannot know the unknown. Now, to see anything new, totally new, the mind must be empty of all the past. Yes. Truth or God or whatever name you like to give to it must be new, not something which is the result of propaganda, which is the result of conditioning. I mean, a Christian is conditioned by 2,000 years of propaganda, and the Hindu and the Buddhist for 10,000 years or more or less. So God or truth is, according to them, is the result of propaganda. And that's not truth. Truth is something living every day. Therefore, the mind must be empty to look at that truth.
Right, you sort of wipe the slate clean.
That is meditation.
And that's meditation. Then you get this total relaxed perception of what is.
What is, that's right. What is not a thing that is static. It's a thing that is extraordinarily alive. And therefore, the mind that is really in meditation, a meditative mind, is really a very silent mind. And the silence is not the product of suppression of noise. It is not the opposite of noise. It is this result. It comes when the mind has completely understood itself. and therefore no movement at all takes place. And which means the body must be completely quiet. The brain cell, this is an extraordinary thing if one has observed it, the brain cells themselves become quiet. And then in that silence, everything happens.
Yes.
That is real meditation, not all this phony acceptance of authority and repetition of words and all that business. That's all nonsense.